I would like to thank AOS for giving me this opportunity. I am presenting on ganglion cell loss in alcohol and tobacco toxicity. Psychoactive substance abuse in India continues to be an substantiative problem for individuals as well as for the society. Of the various substances, alcohol and tobacco are most commonly abused substances, with majority of the people being dependent on them. Tobacco and alcohol usage is more prevalent in men, rural population, illiterates and poor section of the society. The exact pathogenesis of toxic optic neuropathy resulting from tobacco and alcohol is not established and is probably multifactorial, but cyanide in tobacco, smoke and malnutrition due to alcohol intake appears to be the most important causative factors. Tobacco smoking is a powerful risk factor and conducive to various eye diseases, including the development of cataract, glaucoma, retinal vascular disorders and age-related macular degenerations. Tobacco amblyopia is most common ocular diseases related to its use. Our aim and objective of the study is to assess the ganglion cell thickness plus inner plexiform layer thickness and retinal nerve fiber layer thickness in chronic alcohol and tobacco users, and to correlate the degree of GCL plus IPL thinning and RNFL thinning with severity of alcohol and tobacco use. It is a prospective observational cross-sectional study, was conducted from August 2008 to June 2019 in a tertiary eye care center in southern India. Ethical clearance was taken from the Institutional Review Board was obtained. All chronic alcohol and tobacco users were included, and who are on drugs like ethambutol and isoniazid were excluded, and who are with diabetes, renal failure and multiple sclerosis and glaucomatous disc changes and other causes of disc pallor were excluded. Demographic data such as age and gender were collected. Ophthalmic examination include best corrected visual acuity by Snellen's chart and color vision using Ishihara's pseudo isochromatic plates. Detailed slit lamp examination of anterior segment including pupillary reactions and IOP were assessed. Fundus photograph was taken especially to look for temporal pallor of the optic disc, and GCL plus IPL thickness and RFNL thickness was measured using optic disc cube 200 into 200 and macula cube 512 into 128 in spectral domain OCT of Carl Zeiss. PanoMap future in OCT is used to assess GCL plus IPL thickness and RFNL thickness together in one report. This is the fundus photograph of a subject with both eyes showing temporal pallor. And this is the PanoMap report of subject. In macular area, it is divided into six quadrants, like superior, inferior, and superotemporal, inferotemporal, inferonasals, and superonasal. And it gives minimum value of GCL plus IPL thickness. And it also shows it is the thin. There is a temporal RNFL thinning in both eyes. And just for comparison, I am showing a HD21 line scan of healthy and toxic patient. Here you can clearly differentiate inner retinal layers like nerve fiber layer and inner plexiform layers. Here it is poorly differentiated inner retinal layers in a toxicity patient. Smoking consumption is calculated as pack years through an online calculator, smokingpackyears.com, and alcohol consumption as quantity in milliliters for years. We divided the subjects into two groups to know whether the chronicity of the substance abuse has any effect on GCL plus IPL and temporal RNFL. Smoking consumption is divided into two groups like less than 10 years and more than 10 years, and alcohol consumption into two groups as less than 20 years and more than 20 years. All data was entered in MS Excel, analyzed through SPSS version 22. Descriptive statistics were represented with percentages, mean and standard deviation. Independent t-test is applied to find significance. P-value less than 0.5 was considered as statistically significant. A total of 30 eyes of 15 cases were included in the study. All 15 were male, and mean age group of less than 10 pack years is 47.9 plus 13.33 years, and more than 10 pack years is 47.8 plus 11.97 years. And alcohol group less than 20 years who are consuming alcohol is mean age is 41.38 plus or minus 7.71, and more than 20 years alcohol is 55.37 55 years, less than plus or minus 13.12. Among 15 cases in study, 2 cases has normal color vision. In those 4 eyes, GCL IPL thickness and temporal RNFL thickness were normal. This is the smoking consumption. This is the table showing less than 10 years and more than 10 years. The mean visual acuity is better in less than 10 years group as compared to more than 10 years, and statistically significant in all, like GCL plus IPL thickness and temporal RNFL thickness, it is there. Similarly, in alcohol consumption, there is not much statistical significance, but definitely there is a more loss of vision and more GCL GCL thickness is less in more than 20 years group. Discussion: the mechanism of primary insult to the mitochondria that disrupts the process of oxidative phosphorylation causing axonal loss, which preferentially affects the parvocellular neurons in papillomacular bundle, thus resulting in thinning and GCL plus IPL and RNFL thickness. In this study, most of the cases are chronic abusers, so there is significant visual acuity loss, GCL, IPL and temporal RNFL loss also. Next slide.
You have exceeded your time already. Yep. So you can conclude, no problem.
There will be more in chronic consumers, there will be more loss of GCL plus IPL and retinal nerve fiber layer will be more loss in the who are consuming more pack years and more consuming more number of alcohol, more quantity of alcohol per years. And in alcohol also there is more loss who are drinking like local drinks like Sara Gudumba, there will be more loss in GCL plus IPL.
So what is the normally what happens to the GCL IPL layer as we age?
It
thins out. So people who are consuming alcohol for 20 or 30 years are likely to be older than people who have consumed for 10 years generally, because somebody who is 20 year old couldn't have consumed for 30 years. So there is obviously
actually
a natural delay.
If we do a case control study If we do case control study with age matched controls, then it will be an ideal study. That is one of my limitation.
Yes, yes. So that's the thing. So it's such a case study, the validity will actually come only if we are able to document the natural decline over time versus this.
Another thing is, none of the alcoholics will admit to the exact quantity, and smokers also will not.
It's a subjective.
Always that is limitation.
Very generalized, you say.
Yeah.
There is no
exact quantity we
cannot
measure.
So this is a generalized thing which is known already.